Today I'm going to show you how to make your own DIY LED ultrasonic distance meter using Arduino Nano. This is a project anyone can do. You may remember back in April I made something very similar to this using a 16x2 LCD screen. That LCD screen is kind of hard to see unless you're right up on it. And I'm putting this in the garage, and I want to be able to see, in this case, indicator lights as I'm pulling the car into the garage. And I think with the LED lights, this is a really good option for that environment. Since it's going in the garage, it doesn't have to look great. I just used a bunch of wood that I had on hand. For instance, this is a craft plywood. And I used a couple pieces of thicker wood that I had out in the garage just for support of the switch and support of the command strips on the top and the bottom. You can see it's not even cut straight. I did it with a jigsaw. So you can use anything you want. You can certainly use nicer wood and make it look nice, but that's not the case for me. And then I just cut a hole right here in the middle with a jigsaw to place the sensor there. And I attached everything on the back, soldered and glued. I used hot glue, which works really well. And I'll show you how to do every step of that. Let's get started. Today I'll be using 4 male to female jumpers. I'll just use these directly on the HCSR04 or HCSR04 ultrasonic sensor. I've got some solder, some lead-free solder. Got a switch. Got the Arduino Nano. Got the breakout board or the adapter board. Got command strips. Got 8 LED. I've got 3 red, 3 green, 2 yellow. I've got 8 220 ohm resistors. I've got some 22 gauge wire. I have black and red that I'll use to connect the LEDs and the switch to the microcontroller. I've got a something to hold my components while I'm soldering, although I don't like this very much, but it'll have to do. And I have a cheap but reliable soldering iron. I don't want to forget the safety glasses. It's a little bit overkill, but it's all I have. And you also want to use, or I'm using, just some craft board, cheap craft board, real flexible. I use that to mount my project on. So this is what my circuit looked like on my breadboard. I've got my Arduino Nano down here. And as you can see, I've got 2 wires connected to my 5 volt. One wire feeds power to the sensor over here. The other wire, the 5 volt wire, is connected to my switch. And also there's one ground wire, and that's connected to my switch as well. I switch it on and off, and this wire on the other side of my switch is connected to the ground rail, so I can control the LEDs and the sensor by switching that on and off. If you look over here, the white cable is the ground wire to the sensor, to the ultrasonic sensor. And the green is the 5 volt wire I mentioned just a second ago, and that feeds power to the sensor. All of my connections are made on the digital pins of the Arduino board, starting with pin 2. Pin 2 is the echo pin. Pin 3 is the trigger pin of my ultrasonic sensor. If you look down here at the LEDs, you can put this in whatever order you want, but I started down here, this is pin 11. And then respectively, you've got pin 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Pin 11 LED is the first green LED, and that is the furthest distance that the sensor will detect. And the last LED here is red, and that is pin 4, and that indicates the closest distance that the sensor will detect. The negative or the ground pin of the LED is connected to a 220 ohm resistor, and that is connected to the ground rail up here. The positive pin of the LED is connected to each of the pins that I just mentioned. And I have a 220 ohm resistor for each LED. So overall, it's a pretty simple circuit. Hopefully it wasn't too confusing. I will also include the schematic so that you can make your own connections properly, and it'll be less confusing. This shows you how the sensor, the switch, and the LEDs are connected to the microcontroller. It's a little bit messy at the moment, but we park right in front of this shelving unit. So I went outside to determine where the LEDs needed to be so that we can see them from inside the car when we're pulling in, and where the ultrasonic sensor needed to be for it to accurately detect the vehicle. So I grabbed one of these craft boards and I measured 20 inches in length, and I just cut it with a jigsaw right here on a stool. I traced the outline of the sensor on the back side of the board so nobody could see it. I used a drill to put a hole in the center of that rectangle. Then I used a jigsaw to widen that hole gradually until that sensor fit in there. Now that my sensor fits, it's time to drill some holes for the LEDs. I went outside and measured these 1 inch apart, and I drilled a hole through them. It takes a 3/64 drill bit, if you're wondering. At least that's what I used. And using hot glue on each LED will hold it in place. Here's a look at the sensor after it's been glued in place here. You can see that I just try to get the glue mostly on the PCB board. For the sensor, I went ahead and used the male to female wires just because it was easier than soldering. The red wire coming out of the Nano is the 5-volt wire, and you can see the white VCC wire from my sensor is soldered to that. The orange wire is the ground wire of the sensor, and it's also soldered to the ground wire for the board on the back. And this is the view from the front. After it's been glued in place, looks much better than it did before. Here's a look at the Nano board after it's been glued in place. And you can see I use glue on a lot of the wires to keep them down so I don't have wires flopping around everywhere. And as you can see, the red wires here on the other side of the board here, those all go to LEDs. I've got my switch here, and that is glued on three sides with two larger blocks of wood to hold it for stability, and it does a pretty good job. Here's another look at the red wires that connect to the LEDs, and when you're soldering these, you might want to start with the shortest red wire first. That way you can move the other wires out of the way rather than trying to solder between the longer wires that you've already perhaps connected. Here you can see I pushed the ground pin of the LED to the right, flat against the board. I trimmed the positive lead and then pushed it to the left, flat against the board, to give it a cleaner look. This brown wire is the ground wire that comes out of the Nano board, and it goes directly to the switch. And the green wire is the ground wire from the switch that is soldered to the ground line for the LEDs, and also the same ground line for the ultrasonic sensor. Here is the sketch for the LED distance meter, and up here you're going to define the connections. For instance, trig pin is at pin 3 on your microcontroller. The echo pin is at 2. Here you're going to define your LED pins, all 8 of them, at pin 4 to 11. And down here in setup, you're going to set the trigger pin as an output and the echo pin as an input, and all 8 LEDs as an output. And the rest of the code determines when the LEDs will light up depending on the distance the object is from the sensor. So LED 1 is our LED at pin 4, that's our red LED at the very top of our board that I made, and it will light up when the object is at or less than a distance of 7. Otherwise, it'll be low, it'll be off. The LED won't light up. And you do that for each LED. The next one is a distance of 14. The LED below that will light up when the object is at a distance of 14 or less than 14. Otherwise, that LED will not light up. And then you go all the way up to LED 8, which is the first green LED on the bottom, and it will light up when the object is at 56, a distance of 56 or less than. So otherwise, if it's further than a distance of 56, it will not light up. So that's it for this. Pretty short and sweet. So here's a look at what the car currently looks like, and it looks like today it's actually touching. It's actually touching the shelf. It's a van, so there's very little room left in the front or the back once we pull it in. It's pretty big. Here is a look at the distance meter from inside the vehicle. And I also recorded the meter in action outside the vehicle, which you can see a little bit better. And it works just as it should. Now, if I lean over the edge here and see how much room is between the shelf and the van, it's perfect. And then I can just reach over, use that switch to shut it off. There we go.
Well, that's all I've got for today. If you did this project, let me know how it went. Let me know what you think. If you got value out of this video, be sure to hit the like button. And also, if you like videos like this, be sure to subscribe to the channel. And I will post the code to the Facebook page. Until next time, my name's Brad. Take care.